Hello, hello, hello. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's me, it's me, it's me, Buchanan. Yeah, I got off work. And God bless y'all. You know, I pray that you had a wonderful, marvelous day so far. I pray that your night be just as blessed. Because if you're listening to this, you got to have ears and you will laugh. So God bless you. Anyway, yes, yes, I'm feeling myself. I'm sorry about this morning's upload. I was in a hurry and I was trying to carry the computer with me while I tried to talk to you and get dressed and turn around. I talked for probably 25 minutes and before I realized that it wasn't, I wasn't recording correctly. So I wasn't recording. And I don't really listen to all my stuff I talk about. I just say it and only check it to see if it's uploaded correctly. So anyway, I was talking about, yeah, they talked about they can't speak English and all this and that, right? Okay, it worked. Okay. All right. Okay. So anyway, yeah, I should get up and do my little dance. Anyway, right. Oh, yeah, they don't speak English. So they moved me from the land I was on. They moved me to another land. So I'm over there working, right? Okay, so they put me with people that don't speak English, right? So anyway, I'm over with them and we working and stuff like that. So all of a sudden, me don't speak no English. I was good. That's okay. So I did my little hand gesture to show her what I was trying to say. Cool. So later on, another lady comes over. Y'all need to get one of these shirts right here. They'll speak English when you wear these shirts. And like I said, I'm not being offensive. I'm just being real with you. How my day went. And what happened and what I know. I don't know if you can see it. Okay. I'm up. I'm down. It's dark. Sundays were made for church and brunch. Hello, you did see that, how big it is. That's what I had on. And you know I'm a little heavy chested, and that's not being perverted, but hello. So it was seen. Had my little do-rag on my head, like, not a do-rag, but I wore a rag on my head. I wore that today because it's all that stuff getting in my head. Anyway, like I said, so I'm at work, right? So a lady comes over, and she started talking in English. Hello. She said, I love your shirt. She said, I like what your shirt says. Basically, some of it was a little lost in translation, but look, what she was saying was, I love your shirt, and he's the one. Hello, is it universal or what? She's talking about Jesus, my Father, my Savior, my all in all. She knows about Jesus. That's what I'm talking about. That's what makes us one. If you love my Father, we one. Hey, I ain't against you. I'm for you. Anyway, she said, yeah. And she said, I'm from Yugoslavia. Hello. Mm-hmm. Not only did she introduce herself, a dude introduced himself too to me. I'm not saying his name, but I got it. He asked me my name out here. What did I tell you? Yeah, well, y'all think I'm crazy. I'm tripping. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm just running my mouth. Yeah, right. Like I'm telling you, you better wake up. Y'all better wake up. And I ain't talking about smelling no coffee. Anyway, so she's talking to me, and she's like, yeah, he's the one. And what she said was beautiful. She said, yes. She said, brunch. She knew brunch. Feel me. Not only can she speak it, but she can read it. But y'all thought I was playing. Yeah. Go ahead on. Yeah. She said this, though. This is beautiful. It touched my soul, my spirit. Man, I started to tear up, but I had to keep working. She said, my family. She said, we sit down. I don't need to be trying to talk like no bad, but the accent is beautiful. Don't get me twisted. Beautiful. Can you imagine Jesus? Jesus was Aramaic, right? You know what I'm saying? Jesus, Jew, Aramaic, whatever. Jesus was everything for real. You know, he can speak every language there is. So that language is beautiful, beautiful. And but she's speaking English, and she said, yeah, my family, we sat down together at the table. And we eat, she did her hand, eat together. That's what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? We take a dismiss our elderly people, and I'm going to crack a joke, but hey, hello. Yeah, we dismiss our elderly people, our grandma, great-grandma. We're putting them in nursing homes and getting rid of them and leaving them out on their own where they don't even have much food to eat and can't pay their bills, living on the streets. But they take care of their family, familia. Yeah, family. They take care of their family. Grandma, grandpa, everybody probably working there together. Because they won. They keep it together. And that's what I'm saying to black people. When they cut off welfare, not saying we all on it, but when there's a welfare, no medical like I don't have. When all of that stuff like that is gone, where are we going to go? Uh-huh. Yeah. All them little people that we setting up, well, not we, but people setting up getting high with, you thinking that's your friend. Yeah, they tell you, oh, dude, you know you need a place, you down? Yeah, that's why you got that, you getting that high off on. You know what I'm saying? You got that little change in your pocket. It's cool. You got your own place. But let you fall down. Let you lose your place. Let you lose your little income and your little hustle change you got. See if them people going to bring you in. Those people like that, different nationality, different people that come from different cultures, a lot of them, not all, but a lot of them, they'll take and bring their family in. They'll live 10. How many of us can live 10 deep in a half together? I'll wait. I'll wait. How many of us can live 5 in a half together? I'll wait. Especially when 2 or 3 of us don't have no income. I'll wait. I'll wait. Yeah, exactly. So like I said, we better get out here and we need to vote. We need to make our voices heard. We need to make some changes. We need to ask, okay, yeah, you want to be the judge? You want to be the politician? Okay, let's go way back. Let's dig. Let's dig deep. Let's look at your history. I don't want to hear what you're talking about kissing the babies and all that stuff with their snotty noses and all this type of thing. I don't want to see that boo-boo at all. I want to know, who did you vote for in 1962 and 65? What was you doing? Who, you know, I ain't in all your marriage thing like that, but, you know, who did you vote for? Let me see your politics. Your politics, a political record. You know what I'm saying? Let's look at that. A little bit about your family. Let's check some of that out. Yeah, let's check that out. What you really about? Yeah. And while I'm talking, I did the walking. I made sure that I renewed my voter status. Yes, I did. With my correct address and my correct telephone number. Yes, I did. While I'm talking, I'm walking. I made sure of that. And as a matter of fact, I used to be independent, but now I'm Democrat. Hello? Am I Democrat? I am a Democratic. Okay, I'll work on that later on. But anyway, yeah. I'm not going to tell you to do something I'm not doing. I'm not going to push you when I'm not pushing myself. Feel that. For real, for real. That's real talk. But like I said, man, I seen some stuff. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? We had a beautiful moment, but it got ugly later on. Yeah, she come over trying to tell me this, and then you add little stuff on what I need to do. Man, I'm like, woo! Woo! Sweet Jesus. Like my little cousin Precious say, Jesus, take the wheel. I'm like, Lord Jesus, I couldn't think of that one at the time. I thought a whole lot of more things, but I was like, you know. And then, you know, I got into my prayer life. I got with Jesus. You know, what would Jesus do? Before I got to Jesus, I was thinking about Moses and Joshua, getting ready to do some stuff. But then I had to be Christ-like. And then I thought about these people, some of them, you know, you feel, she kept hollering, I've been here 4 years, I've been here 4 years. I'm like, more power to you, for real. But, you know, I feel a little bit, I understand people feeling threatened with the economy the way it is, you know what I'm saying? So I understood a little bit, she felt threatened. That not just me, anybody coming in, all of us new ones coming in. So, you know, especially us black people, because, you know, we will work. When we have to, we work. We work. We ain't playing. So, I mean, I understand that. Plus, I understand I had to feel what she was feeling. I had to step in her shoes. You know, they come from a different culture. Really not, you know, we just forget about, you know, all them little beatings and stuff somewhere in there. You know what I'm saying? We forget about turmoil and crisis, really, you know, because we really far away from some of them beatings, but, you know, we not far away from the killings, you know, but we're far away from constant brutality, so a lot of them come here, and this is like Eden, the Garden of Eden to them, so, you know, I understood her little roughness a little bit, so, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I was squashing it, I'm cooling, it shocked her. Because they look for a black person that want to act out all the time. And I always never, woo, thank you, Jesus. Don't even let that line come out of your mouth. It was getting ready to come out, but I caught it. Look, y'all saw it. Yeah, I ain't, anyway, at that time, I did not act like they thought I was going to act, you know. I didn't do it, you know. So, like I said, it was all good. It's all good, you know. Somebody called me on the phone, you know, the chick was talking all that. She was going to tell me about a job, the black chick. She ain't said nothing. She talking about whatever. I'm not even worrying about her. You know, I'm not stupid. You probably ran back trying to say she's, you know, she's looking for another job, whatever. So they try to, you know, make me comfortable. So, you know, I ain't even with that. You know what I'm saying? But my people, hello, I'm not even worrying about that for real. That's why I ain't even had no more conversation with her. I'm here to get my ass and do you. Do you. That's where a lot of times you got to kind of separate and keep focused. I got to keep focused. I'm not here playing games with you. So anyway, like I said, when I got to my car, I had a car offer me another job. So that door's open. As a matter of fact, the other company that I always get, they still want me to come back, and I didn't get to go to the job. So hello, which I got to work two jobs anyway it goes, because I need to build my money back up. So, you know what I'm saying? I ain't got no choice. So right now, so it is what it is. But one day, I'll be in Paris. Sipping on. Anyway, like I said, I'm glad I made it through the week. You know what I'm saying? Wednesday, Thursday, I made it. I thank God for that. You know what I'm saying? I was listening to Steve Harvey in the mornings as I go to work, and I caught him on two occasions. And basically, you know, he was hitting me upside my head, and I feel it, you know, which I had already started saying I was grateful, you know. But yeah, he was talking about, we sitting there, and we whining and talking about where we at, and I'm guilty of that. You know, like, darn God, I didn't want to be there. You know, I hated the distance, but then God moved me, and it's not the same thing, same money. But really, it is. I'm straight. But, you know, it's just, but then that's why I had to just shut up and say, look, I'm not going to complain. I thank God because I was close, and I had said that the other day. I said, thank God, you know, because I'm glad to see daylight. I'm glad to get home to check out my house. You know what I'm saying? Because you're sitting at work and you're worrying about down, you know, I'm a cut. What's she doing? You know, is she doing something to my hair? You know, is my hair burned down or what? You know, that stuff do, it enters my mind. You know, like what's going on at my house when I'm not hurt. So, you know, it ain't nothing. You break in, it ain't nothing in here to steal. It's not like that. It's just, you know, somebody damaging your property and doing stuff to your house. You know what I'm saying? In place of wanting to do something to you. Y'all feel me? So, like I said, though, I'm grateful. I'm grateful to God. Like I said, I thank God. The car took me all the way to work today, and the God humbled me. When I went to the store for lunchtime to go give me something to eat, the guy was there, and his car broke down, and somebody tried to give him a jump, and he couldn't take a jump. And then I'm turning my car, and it wasn't starting, and he looked at me, and we laughed, you know. And then I was like, yeah. I said, man's my alternator. He said, man's my starter. I said, sometimes you can hit it. He said, I already did that. I said, oh, man, well, I know what you're going through. And then my car turned over, and I was grateful. And that was God letting me know, look at you. You know what I'm saying? Look at you. You riding. Thank you, Jesus. I'm able to ride back and forth. I'm able to breathe. I'm working in a place where using my asthma would kick in. By God's grace and mercy, haven't been sick. God's good. You know what I'm saying? I got my health and my strength. You know right now. You know what I'm saying? Not only did he wake me up this morning and give me a job to go to, but he gave me the ability to work the job. You know, even though she coming to me talking about, I tell y'all what I do, it'll blow your mind. You couldn't fathom in a million years. You wouldn't fathom in a million years what kind of job God got me doing. And it's God, believe me, it's God. I'm doing what Jesus do. Y'all know what he did when he was hurt. I'm not even going to tell you. But you better pick up your Bible. Anybody know what Jesus did, it's exactly what I'm doing. I don't even know I know a little bit why he's doing it. But anyway, that's what I do. And then she's going to turn around. You've been there 4 years and you want me to take and pick this up and I'm supposed to know how to use it after some hours of training. I was like, whew. I've been singing all day. I was just singing. You know I can't sing, so I was singing anyway. Yeah, to keep my peace of mind, because all I was thinking about, I can't wait till 4 o'clock. I'm dancing. I was singing everything. And thank God time went back fast. God is good. I thank God that he allowed me to be a part of time. You know what I'm saying? To have knowledge of time. I thank God. I thank God for the brain in my head. I thank God that I'm not crazy today. I might talk like, act like, and you might think it, but believe me, I've been insane before. God has renewed my man. I thank God. I'm a walking, talking testimony. I know how good God is. I don't even like the word good. I like what that guy said. What he said? He said, good. You know what I'm saying? I got feet. I can walk. Thank God my feet should be hurting. That my toes can't hurt a little bit. You know what I'm saying? But yeah. I got some money in my pocket. I can tithe. I didn't go to church Wednesday, but I can tithe. I can give something, get back to God and tell him thank you. I can help somebody else. And believe it or not, you know who made that call today, don't you? Which they called me the other day. Hadn't heard from the little pickles. You know them grandbabies. Yeah. Oh, yeah, the grandbabies called. And my oldest grandson, he sound like a grown man in the background. I forgot school was out. So, yeah, God's given me the opportunity to do something for my grandbabies. Not a lot, but a little something. Because I've learned, you know, all that splurging now. Get what you need, Janice. That's all you can do. Get what you need. Nothing else. You know, I'm tired of running around looking real bummy. You know what I'm saying? Scarves on my head, you know, and all that. I need my hair cut again. But, yeah, I like wearing my hair like this because it's comfortable. You know, I need to stop trying to dad, though, but I thank God. I'm so thankful, you know. Like I said, I might complain, and I said I need to stop complaining, but hello, I got to vent somehow. But I thank God for his goodness, his grace, and his mercy, you know. And if I didn't have no problems, I wouldn't know that God could solve them. But I'm not going to sit here and say, yeah, I'm glad I got them. So y'all can forget that. But anyway, I thank God that I had a home to come home to. Could have been burned down, earthquake, tornado, anything could have happened to the house. Thank God. House, apartment, thank God. You know, we need to be thankful. Not just me, but, you know, I'm telling you what I'm thankful for. I'm glad that I thank God that the car made it here. Hello. You know, I thank God that the car is running, which is a miracle. Me and the lady and the guys, we was talking about that today. You know, she said her car do the same thing, but it's her battery. So I'm like, hello, I don't know, but thank you, Jesus, you know. And I can hear some music in the car today. Couldn't do that at first. So I have so many things to be thankful for. Thank God I done picked up things heavy. I'm talking about heavy, like a dumbbell today. Thank God I don't feel it right now, but you know I'm going to feel it in the morning. I'm talking about working chest and everything. Oh, God bless y'all men. God bless you men. Oh, God bless you men and all your strength. Woo, Lord Jesus, bless you. It's a man's work, but it wouldn't be nothing without a woman or a girl. Yeah, James Brown, my little cousin Carol, she loved James Brown. Oh my God, she loved James Brown, but yeah, he said it. But yeah, I'm not going to run out here talking about I can do everything a man can do. No, y'all can have that right there. Like I said, I don't know, God put me here, but oh Lord Jesus, not my will, his will be done. I said, no, she didn't. I'm talking about, woo, yeah, but everybody got to eat. That's one thing I had to look at. Woman, man job, boy job, girl job, midget job, tall person job, invisible person job. So yeah, we got to work, we got to do something, we got to have some type of income. But like I said, any type of income. And what I want to say today, what I was saying this morning, and God just brought it back to me. Thank you, Jesus. See, that's what I'm talking about. His love endures forever. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Yeah, we better get away from people. I don't know about you. Like I said, I done been through so many toils and tribulations. Lord Jesus. I ain't lying. He had to shake me to wake me. He had to take me through some things. To open my eyes to see some things. But believe me, my eyes are open now. But honey, get away from somebody talking about, ooh, you don't need to be on welfare. You need to go get you a job. That's what's wrong with you people now. You don't want to work. You want somebody to give you something. Honey, you better get away from them. You better run. You better run. Yeah, that's all sweet and dandy if you can. But people fail to realize there's a lot of people that been out here that only been maybe on welfare a period of time. They never had job experience. Experience. That came out real funny, didn't it? Experience. And that's true. A lot of people don't know how to work with people. Like I said, I know how to work in a factory, warehouse, any job you name, I could do it. But I am not a restaurant. I'm not a numbers person. I can work the registers. Registers will work for themselves. But dealing with people, nah, that's not my forte. See, I know my limits. That's not me. And so here it is. A lot of people are quick to hurry up and say you need to get a job, but then a lot of people are not job savvy, and then they get on a job, which the door opens for them, and 9 out of 10 times it might be a restaurant, their first job. I'm not going to name restaurants, because a lot of people try to damn certain cheap, they call cheap restaurants, but people fail to realize when you need to pay some bills, it don't matter where you work. If you still got to scrub some floors, long as you paying your bills, hold your head up. Don't let nobody ever make you feel like holding your head down. Because you're doing what you have to do. Anyway, like I said, some people get on jobs and they're rushed. Like these programs. Instead of trying to help a person with their own TANF, welfare, AFDC, they hurry up and cut you out as soon as you start making money, and then you fall. Been there, done that. So you get these people, you push them in these restaurant places, are dealing with people, and they're not used to dealing with people. So as soon as somebody take and throw some fries at them, they over the counter. So don't let nobody define you. Don't let nobody tell you about your journey. Don't let nobody tell you about your place in life. Don't let nobody push you into something that you're not ready for or you're not, thank you Jesus, equipped to handle. Like I said, I'm not saying run around here and march. Oh, I'm glad I'm on TANF. I'm glad I get ABC. I'm glad I get food stamps. Nah, but at the same time, don't run around here holding your head down, talking about you said or scared to speak about it. Like I said, you know I opened my mouth when people was running around doing that stuff, trying to talk about when people live in the projects, this and that, and all that little stuff they had to say. Yeah, I held my peace for a minute, but I hurried up, spoke up. I live in the project. I was telling somebody, as a matter of fact, today, the lady was talking, she trying to hurry up, sugarcoat it, talking about, some people we end up knowing, we know the same name. And she said, yeah, the ones I know live here. I said, well, and the ones I know live in the project. And like, she was like, the ones I know, I used to live in Clarksville. She looking at me like, and what? Why should I be ashamed of where I came from? I'm not. I'm not ashamed of where I came from. I thank God I came from Clarksville Housing Project. I am very happy. Came out of Portland too. I am not that happy for that one, but I'm glad I came out of Clarksville. I have my beautiful friends. Beautiful. I wouldn't trade my friendship for nothing. Like I said, the friend that I have right now to this day, I'm talking about to this right now, this second, this minute. I'm talking about right now, October the 6th. 2017. My friend Bobby, we've been friends for since before 75, 70, then the 70s, 60s, 67, 6, wow. Over 30 to 40 years. Yeah, 40 something years we've been friends. And I have other people that we still identify as friends. The one I dreamed about, God spoke her name to me. Being on her, she accepted my friend request. I came out of Clarksville, my friend that God spoke to me about, she lived over off of Clay or Hancock, but we all attended the Omar Carmichael together. I'm talking about real friends, real teachers, had black teachers when I went to school. That's another subject, I'll talk about that another time. Right now, I went to the store, it's a little dude off of Dixie Highway, O's, I can't really name him, but I got me some greens, they got turkey in them, he said. And I got me some perch, and I'm getting ready to sit down here, I'm getting ready to eat, watch my movie. I'm not going to be distracted by the other little things that try to pop off, trying to distract me. I'm not going to do it today. No, I'm not. I'm going to stay in my thankful mode. I'm going to catch me a little movie, and I'm blessed, and I'm highly favored. And if it's God's will, tomorrow I would like to put me on some nice little fresh little fit, because I got me a little fit. Yes, I did. I got me a little deal on some boots. I waited them out. Got me a little thing, like I said, but I got one more and I'm done. Just like I did. I went to Walmart, got all my shirts, $2, $3, $1, took me through my summer. My kids got that for me for Mother's Day. They gave me a gift. They gave me some money, and I took the money and bought me some my little summer stuff, and I got through because I'm learning the budget. That's why I said every time I looked around, I was paying. But like I said, that's the past. With you? I've never met y'all. But anyway, like my Tony Montana, you know what I'm saying? That's the past. I'm here now. I just watched it. I watched it again, my sky face. But anyway, you know what I'm saying? Let's be Christian. But anyway, you know, I love the Lord, but y'all know, you know, I act out and I say some little words. Oh my God, I didn't even edit the other one. But you know, I'm getting a whole lot of Spanish people start following me on Wichita, but you know, they know it too. I'm not saying nothing that's a lie. They know what I'm saying is true. But you know, at work, I was saying some stuff that was pissing me out. I would say, oh, see what I'm saying? Y'all heard that word anyway. Yeah, she was getting on that nerve. Yeah, man. I hurried up and said, I said, the next job I get, I said, I ain't lying. I'm going to tell them I don't speak English. I ain't lying. I'm just joking with y'all, but you know what I'm saying? Hey, you never know. But yeah, I said, I'm going to say I don't speak English. And I'm going to stand around, and they're going to run around trying to get a translator. And I'm going to play it out. And all I'm going to keep on saying, USA, USA, great, great, USA. That's all I'm going to say. And I'm going to let them try to figure out what language I speak. And that's not throwing hits to nobody. It's just telling the truth. Because, yeah, if I can pull the wool over your ass, so be it. I'm sitting in the dark right now. Look at it. I'm here, but you can't see, you can't make out my features unless you go in and you know how to work your little digital thing and you put a light on it, then you can really see my face. But other than that, oh, you don't. But other than that, you in the dark. Yeah, you in the dark. But like I said, I'm going to run my mouth for a while. You know what I'm saying? So guys say, shut up. You know what I'm saying? I may end up cutting off something if I can't pay this AT&T bill. Hello, and that's due. AT&T is due. LG&E going to be due. The water is not going to come right now. Woo, Lord Jesus. Praise God. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I'm thankful. I ain't even going to get on that. Because thank God right now I have an opportunity to go ahead and pay it. I got it. You know what I'm saying? So thank God for today. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, like I said, though, you know, we sitting in the dark right now. You can't see my face. But you know, you making out a lie and I'm hurt. And that's what I'm saying. Y'all better open your eyes and see the light. You better open your eyes. You know, we sitting here in Louisville, Kentucky. You know what I'm saying? And we talking about, oh, man, over in Texas, they had the hurricane over there. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I'm not doom, gloom, and despair. But I'm saying, but for the grace of God, it's not us. But we need to check ourselves. You know what's meant by that. We need to check ourselves. We need to look at ourselves. You know, I'm not saying those things happen to those people because they did something bad. I'm saying that it rains on the just and the unjust. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. It rains on the just and the unjust. Yeah. Like I said, keep on playing. Keep on playing, black people. Keep on playing. Keep on talking about I'm just going to do me about everything. Yeah, I know I said do me earlier. That's because she wasn't talking about nothing. She was trying to waste my time. You know what I'm saying? She's draft snitching. Really, that's what it was. So anyway, that's why I dismissed her. I stayed focused. Thank you, Jesus, and I made it through the day. So I'm not worrying about her. Like I said, altogether, it was a good day. But like I said, we need to wake up because pretty soon, if we don't wake up, all the little benefits, all the things for the needy, not the greedy, for the people that's poor, for the people that's still laying out on the streets. We better care. We better care, man. We better speak up. We better make some changes. We need to start loving one another and embracing one another. Start getting together. Like that lady said, she's from Yugoslavia, and then some of them from Cuba or whatever. But the point is family. And what I like about them, even though she's usually they speak different languages, sometimes they can't understand each other. And then some of them couldn't even get the Spanish out. They spoke English better than the Spanish for real. Hello, that's another story. That ain't another story. It's what I said. But the thing is what she said about family. They were even at the table. I told you that when I was working at the other place. Everywhere, when I see them together, they'll sit together. They'll sit there and they'll share each other's lunch. And that's a beautiful thing. You know, I'm not trying to be offensive about them. I'm telling you the truth about the situation. But that's something that I admire. I respect about them, and I will always respect that about different cultures that do that, that put family first, that sit there and love one another, eat with one another. Because if you look at it, especially in biblical times, Jesus had that. That was an important thing. Even before Jesus came, people would sit together and commune together. And when you eat, it's sharing. It's intimacy. It's an intimate thing. And that's what you do. It wasn't to be interrupted. Nowadays, you know, we fast. We got microwaves and all this. Not many of us, including myself, people don't sit down and eat together, you know, and commune. A lot of family issues and things going on. True that, whatever. But let's get to that. Let's get to that, you know. And like I said, even if you don't have family, I could be your family. We can sit down. We can eat together. I love to eat, man. I was saying at first, I'm going to get my little pouch back now. Hey. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Gotta stop drinking all that pop, though. Mess with your sleep. But God is good. God is awesome. I'm going to get out here and give me something to eat. Like I said, you know, I said what I said. You know, I'm not tripping. I love you. You know what I'm saying? I might get angry with you and, you know, with my people over this or that. You know what I'm saying? But all together right now, y'all know how we are right now. Right now, I'm trying. I'm doing all I can. You know what I'm saying? Oh, thank you, Jesus. See how good he is? He just brought something else to my remembrance, to my memory. Guess what? Guess what? Guess what? Get. Didn't I tell you? I was going to change my name. My name is now Vigilantes for Justice. Oh, yeah. And I got my tax ID number. Whoa. So, I'm not just talking about it. I'm trying to walk. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing the best I can to walk, and I'm doing the best I can to help us. You know, because if you go down for real, I'm going down too. You know, that sounds real serious, didn't you? You know what I'm saying? It'll be like, anyway, y'all know what I'm saying. I'm trying to, you know, but for real, if you falling down, I'm falling too. You know what I'm saying? We all together, you know, and it's like today, the one guy that made a little statement about, you know, it's a man's job, and, you know, basically women should go first on this certain thing. Today, he ended up sitting near me. You know what I'm saying? He kind of young dude, but he sat near me. Then the other one, I noticed they sat by me. Because when the stuff hit the fan, y'all know what that meant. Y'all know what that meant. You know, yeah. They sat by me. Like I said, because it's not I'm bad or whatever. It's that regardless if I'm a woman, I'm black, you black. At the end of the day, boo-boo, that's where it counted. And they seen it, and they feeling it. It's like, oh, wait a minute, we kind of like, well, we came in together. Let me get over here with sister girl, you know, because some stuff is real shady up in here. Come on. Yeah. That's one thing about us, and we lost it. Let me take it back. Some of us have lost it. We as a black people, man, we can get together. It takes Richard Pryor to talk about it. We can get together. We don't even have to say nothing. We already know. We can give each other that look like. We already know it's time to get the up out of here. It's like Richard Pryor told a joke one time. Y'all know, anyway, like I said, you know I'm having a good day because I'm laughing like a mug. Richard Pryor told a joke. He said something broke out or something popped off, you know what I'm saying, in the club. Like, you know, I think it was like a club. He said something popped out. He said, yeah, dude. He said, yeah, they shooting? He said, yeah, it's popping out. He said, which way you going? He said, why you ask that? He said, because I don't want to run over you on my way down. But the lady was talking about it too when we were doing our training. She said, some people, you know, something happens, trying to talk about being camaraderie and all this. But she was talking about, she said, usually like if somebody take off running, everybody run. And I'm just sitting there looking at him like, nah, help her. You know, darn, I'm tripping. But anyway, you know, we black people. You just up, pop off. Oh, we all got. Like my mama's boyfriend, Jay Howe, he used to love messing with your man. His real name was John Russell, my stepdaddy. Man, he used to mess with your man. He said, go to school. When I was in the fifth, sixth grade, he said, go to school and just stand in the highway and just look up in the sky. He said, watch how many people stand there and look up with you. And I did it one day, and everybody stood up looking, trying to see what I was looking at. But yeah, we don't have to say nothing to each other. And I went to our black school, as a matter of fact. My fourth, fifth, sixth grade, my school was all black. You know what I'm saying? There was a couple of white people there, but mostly our school was black. But anyway, yeah, if you are, you know, if something pop out, we look at each other. I will say back to each other, we don't even have to say nothing. That's real talk, and we got some love. That's why I said I can't give up on my people, because we got some real love. It's a lot of us that's real. Man, we real. We know what's real, you know. We been through some stuff. Man, we been through some stuff. Man, I know I've been through some stuff. Man, I look back on my life. Man, I shouldn't even be here. Man, y'all just don't know how many times, man. Anyway, I'm here. I'm alive. And I'm getting ready to eat my greens and my perch fish. So God bless you. God keep you. I'm getting ready. I got time. I'm going to upload this. And today, again, this is part two, really, of whatever the other one was for this morning. Well, 10-6-2017. Today is Friday. God bless your heart and all your parts at 7:29 p.m. See ya. And this will be called, the first one was something, Don't Be Fooled or something. I forgot what it's called. It was called The Birth of a Fool. Yeah. I can look at it on the screen at the bottom. Hey. This will be birth, I ain't fooling. That's what it's going to be called. I ain't fooling. Yeah, I ain't fooling. That's what this is going to be called. So, ta-ta now.